Hey, this is Mike. I'm in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, visiting Sparks Toyota, and I'm checking out a 2016 Toyota Avalon in the XLE trim level. So this is a really smooth, comfortable, and classy vehicle. Super impressed with the features, the styling, and just the overall comfort of the vehicle. So let's go ahead and check it out. You can see it has the 17-inch alloy wheels. And it's all classy looking. It's not like overly gaudy or anything. It's not trying to be, you know, super sporty. This is a really smooth, just easy on the eyes car to me. So you have the ventilated disc brakes there in the front and the solid disc brakes there in the back. Let's take a look at the profile. And the window tint has been added by the dealer, so that doesn't come from the factory like that. So let's take a look here in the front. Check out that grill. It's like a smoked out grill there with the chrome around the outside, and then you have the chrome accent across the front. Looking sharp. So here's your headlights. It's pretty interesting. It's a small projector headlights powered by halogen bulbs, and they're called the Quadra Beam headlight system. So your low beams will be here on the right side, and on the left side is your high beams in a reflector fashion. Then your turn signal will be there at the bottom. So this is what the key looks like. It's a proximity key. It has the lock and unlock buttons there. You can open up the trunk with that button, and you have a panic button. You also have a physical key. You push that button and you can actually pull out a physical key from the inside there. So with the proximity key, all you have to do is have the key with you in your pocket or purse or whatever. And you can lock and unlock the doors without actually taking the key out of your pocket. You can lock the doors by placing your finger right here. It senses the key proximity of the vehicle, it senses your hand position, and it locks the doors. To unlock the door, you just put your hand behind the handle, it senses your hand, and it unlocks the door. Let's take a look here on the passenger side. Now the passenger side door does not have the touch feature, that's only on the driver's side with the proximity key. So here's the inside of the passenger door. It's a combination of a real light tan and the rest is black, and all soft to the touch surfaces around your arm here. And up here is kind of a little bit of soft material as well. So you have that really neat chrome with the satin black there in the center around your window controls and door lock controls. You have a little storage pocket there at the bottom. There's your threshold. You have the power seat here on the passenger side with the heated leather seats. Super comfortable vehicle. Just the position of the seat, the softness of it. You just got to try it for yourself. Plenty of leg room, as you can see there on the floorboard. And the dashboard has a little bit of a wood grain there with the soft to the touch surface, kind of matching the seats there with the color. Down here is a lockable glove compartment, so you can put some stuff in there. It's really big in there. I don't know if you can actually see that. Let's see if I can get a little bit closer. Yeah, and then your cabin filter, you can change those there in the back. Let's take a look here at the window sticker. You can use the pause button to get as much information as you want. Hopefully the camera's picking it up well. Looks like it is. So let's take a look here in the back. There's the inside of the back door. Same styling as the front, pretty much. So here's your back seat, and it has a little bit of a bolster for the end seats, similar to kind of simulating a bucket seat in a way, but it's basically a bench seat, which allows you to have a center passenger. Plenty of leg room for the back seat drivers, including the center portion. It has a small hump there for their legs, but not very much at all compared to some other vehicles. So you can see it has an armrest and cup holders there. It has a lockable pass through to the trunk area. Of course, you can move this out of the way in case you need a center passenger. But it's pretty much a bench seat all the way across with some really comfortable bolsters. You also have a 12-volt power supply under here. so you can charge your cell phone or whatever. In the back, it has little pockets there in the back so you can put your stuff. Handles and lights here in the back as well. Let's take a look here in the back of the vehicle. Looking sharp with the dual exhaust with the chrome tips. You also have the chrome accent across the back. And the tail lights are a combination of LEDs and traditional bulbs. Hopefully you can check out my night video soon, so you can see what this vehicle looks like inside and out at night. All the lighting. So to open up the trunk, you can use the key, of course. You can just push and hold this button here, or, which I'm going to do, there's a button here to the far right. You can kind of feel for it. It's a little bit of a rubber feel. You just push that, and either way, it's going to open up to about that position. So you can easily just reach underneath it and lift it up the rest of the way, like so. And it does have the handle in here to close it. It also has a little place for a little glow-in-the-dark handle, so in case somebody is trapped in the trunk, they can release themselves by pulling that. So there goes your ideas on locking somebody in the trunk. They won't stay in there very long. Okay, so here's the trunk. Very huge space back here. As far as make it go as far as they can to the ends there. Then you have that, you can see your pass-through the seats there. And the seats do not fold down, but it does have a massive amount of cargo space here on the trunk anyway. This is your tag holder for the front of the vehicle in case you need that. Under here, you have your tools for changing your spare tire, which it actually has a spare tire. Some new cars do not have a spare tire, so this one does. You also have, of course, you can utilize some space around the spare tire and here for some cargo. Just kind of storage space there, I guess, if you need to use it. So your fuel door is on the driver's side, which is really good. So it's really easy to get out, pump the gas, get back in the vehicle. And it's a lockable door, but when the vehicle locks, it locks the fuel door as well. So it just takes care of that for you. Otherwise, when the vehicle is unlocked, it'll just be unlocked like so. Has a neat little place to put your cap so you don't lose it and it's out of the way and it doesn't dangle down and scratch your paint while you're pumping gas. So to start the vehicle, as long as you have the key inside, you can be in your pocket or whatever, just put your foot on the brake and push this button. And check this out, watch the screens when I start it up, it's pretty neat. You kind of have that wave that goes through both screens, isn't that neat? Take a look here in the floorboard. There's your very simple design here. You've got your left foot, place to put your left foot. You have your accelerator and brake pedal there. Plenty of leg room. It's all, you know, very simple. Nothing's going to get in your way. And then you have your parking brake right here. So let's go ahead and take a look under the hood. So to open up the hood, just a little bit to the right of the emblem, right of center, is right under here is a little latch that you lift up. And then you lift the hood up just a little ways and it goes up the rest of the way by itself. There's your latch there. Okay, so here it is underneath the plastic, by the way. You can see a little bit of the engine. It's a V6. And it's a 3.5 liter V6, 268 horsepower. And it's paired to a 6-speed automatic transmission, electronically controlled transmission. There's your strut towers there, and they're connected with a beam across the top to kind of help stabilize the front end. But overall, everything is well designed, as far as doesn't look too cluttered, it doesn't look overly complicated. Plastic cover could go, I guess. That's just my opinion. Can actually see a little bit of engine around here in the front, so they tried to hide it from us, but they didn't cover it completely. Take a look here on the driver's side, especially just like the other side, except for it has some more buttons. All the power windows are automatic, so front, back, it doesn't matter. One touch, up and down. So let's go ahead and roll it up. a little ways just to show you, hopefully you can see this, that is two panes of glass with an acoustic material on the inside, which helps with, you know, sound deadening and stuff like that. And check it out, when I roll it up, it goes up quickly and then slows at the end. Same thing when you go down. It goes quickly and then kind of slowly finishes it out. I thought that was pretty interesting. So your door lock controls are here. Your side mirrors are controlled here. You can lock out the other windows by pushing that buttons. In case you don't want kids playing with the windows, you can do that. So right in here, you have your traction control button, which you can turn on. You can turn off. It's automatically on. And then there's a button to open up your trunk. Power adjustments on the driver's side seat with the power four-way lumbar support, so you can go in and out, up and down, and really fine-tune your lumbar support on your back. And that's part of the reason why the seat is so comfortable. You got to really check it out yourself. And right in here, you have this really cool little storage pocket. So you can, it's a felt line storage pocket. I guess you can put like some change or just small items there. Okay, here we are on the inside, 2016 Toyota Avalon XLE. Lots of cool stuff to show off. So let's go ahead and start here on the steering wheel. Now the actual steering column is a tilt and a telescoping steering column, and you can lock it in place with this little lever down here. So the steering column, I mean the steering wheel, is a leather wrapped and stitched, extremely comfortable and smooth, and a little bit of softness there, but not too much, steering wheel. It's really, it doesn't really, it's grippy, but it's not really, I don't know, it's just a really smooth and comfortable, high classy, high quality feeling steering wheel with a pretty good thickness too, so it doesn't dig into your hands while you're driving. So we have quite a few buttons here on the steering wheel. Here on the left side is your volume for your radio, and then you can change through your tracks and your presets using these buttons here. And you have a back button, you have a mode button, which is like cycling through AM, FM, satellite radio, that kind of stuff. Here on the right side, you have your Bluetooth controls. You can, once you pair your phone, you can answer calls, hang up on calls, and make calls using your voice recognition system. You can do other stuff with the voice recognition system. It's really handy because you can stay productive while keeping your hands on the wheel, eyes on the road. Really awesome. I highly recommend learning to use the voice recognition system in your vehicle, if it has it. So this button is a display button, which corresponds to the little screen between the gauges, which we'll get to in a second. Behind the steering wheel here, we have your cruise control. So see if the camera's going to focus in on it. So you just make sure it's turned on by pushing that button. You can set it by going down. You can change through your speeds by going up and down. And then you can pull it in to cancel. And also behind the steering wheel is your paddle shifters. So you have a positive and negative there. This is to change through the gears up. This is to change through the gears down. That's pretty handy, especially going down hills. If you need a downshift, you can get some engine braking that way. Here on the left side is your headlight controls. You have daytime running lights off, automatic, and your daytime running lights are actually just your high beams on really low, just a really low brightness. They're just, that's where the position of your daytime running lights are. There's automatic parking lights, and then there's your headlights. Windshield wiper controls are there on the right. So here's your gauges, really easy to read, and they're all lit up. When they're turned off, then there's like, it's just all black, which is pretty interesting. So you have your RPMs here on the left, your temperature gauge for your engine coolant temperature, and your speedometer there to the right, and your fuel gauge there on the bottom. And you notice it has a little arrow to the left next to that pump, showing you which side your fuel door is on. But right here in the center is this little screen. It's blue, which is very easy on the eyes, and it's easy to read with the white lettering. You have a digital speedometer there at the top, distance to empty just below it, and this vehicle has 9 miles, so you know, some people get confused. This is calculated by your past behavior, so once you start driving the vehicle, this will be more accurate. Right now it's not accurate, so just want to let you know that. Okay, so using this button here, that display button there to the right, I'm going to kind of cycle through and show you this is, you can get some more information here. So go to, you can get your current fuel economy, average fuel economy, and like I said, it's not accurate right now. Scrolling through again, you can get your tire pressure on each tire, which is really interesting and handy. Eco drive level, you can turn that on and off depending on, you know, like say if you want to have, if you want to emphasize on fuel economy, then it's going to cut back a little bit on your performance, but you'll get the best fuel economy possible. Scrolling through again, this is where you can have your turn on and off your digital speed. You can also have your eco indicator light on or off, and that's talking about this little green light up here. And then you, of course, you can change the units from kilometers per hour to miles per hour, that kind of thing. And then it scrolls back to your digital speedometer and your distance empty, which is pretty much your default screen. So you can get a little bit more information. I just want to mention the tire pressure. If you don't actually have to go in there and check it all the time, if there's anything out of spec, it will pop up and let you know, so you don't have to even worry about it really. So let's check out the center stack. We already saw the push button start here, but it's a pretty big layout right here. You do have a touchscreen in the center, CD player for those of you keeping the 90s alive. You got the CD player there at the top, and nice traditional huge knobs here for the volume and tune through the stations. And right here is some buttons, and they're not actually like push buttons that's going to click. They're just kind of like touchscreen soft buttons. So pushing this audio button will take you to the audio screen. You have your favorites there on the left. You can show you what you know, you're in the, right now we're in a satellite radio. We can change that by pushing source. Didn't hit it right. There we go. So you can choose AM, FM, satellite radio, Bluetooth audio, USB input, and auxiliary input. And these two are blacked out because there's nothing plugged into them. So you can choose lots of different ways of playing music through the sound system. Alrighty, so we can, let's go to this home button. And the home button will show you what's going on with your phone and your radio there. So that's what that's for, kind of give you a quick look of what's going on. Apps, you can go in here and you can go into, like say, there's your audio, there's your phone information there. Once you pair your phone, you have access to recent calls, phone book, stuff like that. Let's go into weather. Right, I guess you need an HD signal to find that out, and it might be some apps that go through on your phone which gives you this information too. All right, so over here you have a phone button. You can change through your tracks there. You play and pause for your CD player. So down here is your climate control. You also have a digital clock, which is really handy to have a separate digital clock separate from the touch screen. So that way you know right where to look with your eyes as you're driving to keep an eye on the time. And it's really handy to change. You can adjust it right there. It's really easy, your hour and minutes. Okay, so it's a dual zone, so you have your temperature here on the left. You can change for the driver and passenger. You can sync both of them to where you adjust one, both of them will be the same. And you have an automatic mode, your fan speeds right here, and you can turn your recirculate the air button there. Here's where you change where you want the air to blow, and then you have your front and rear defrosters there on the sides, and the air conditioning. So really, you notice this vehicle is really, I don't know how to explain it, it's just smooth. There's no, it's not overly complicated. You have everything kind of laid out nice and easy to use. Just a really awesome car. Okay, so just down here is a pretty neat storage pocket. So it has this kind of wall here, and you can actually put your phone, lay it over top of this, is what I've done. I thought it works pretty good. And it has this little rest for to hold your phone in place, plus it has this little center place to put your wires in and out. But you can open it up. You also have this felt line place here to put your phone and prop it up in there if you need to. You have two 12 volt power supplies. Auxiliary and USB ports are right there. That's the reason for the place for the wires to go in and out. You have a little light in here too, which is pretty neat. You gotta check out my night video. So here's your shifter, and we'll go ahead and put it in reverse. So we can check out the backup camera, see what it looks like. You see, you have your guidelines there. It's a wide angle view, so you can see all around the back of the car. Let's continue down. There's neutral, there's drive. That's your normal drive position. It's going to cycle through the gears for you. And you have a sport mode here, and you can change through the gears with the paddle shifters in this mode as well. And you can know what gear you're in because it'll show you right here on the screen. So it goes up to 6. So basically, you can, this is just kind of setting the highest gear that it'll go into. So you can, as you're accelerating, change through the gears, or you can limit it by going down to say 4th or 5th gear if you want to have some engine braking. So once you put it in 6th gear, it's just going to be like in a sport mode, which is going to emphasize performance over fuel economy. You can always go back into the regular mode there. You can also, besides your paddle shifters, you can bump it to the up and down to change through the gears, sort of like a ratchet shifter, which is pretty neat. So there's your cup holders right there. Soft to the touch all the way around them. You have your heated seat controls here. You push it, and then you can fine-tune it the temperature that you want. You turn it off, push it to put it out of the way. And here's your drive modes. You have an Eco, Normal, and Sport. Sport's going to give you emphasis on performance. Normal is just kind of in between. Eco mode, emphasis on fuel economy. So that's the basics of that. So here's your armrest, and it's a pretty good size armrest. It slides forward and back just slightly in case you want to have a little bit more of a comfortable position. And it's big enough to share with your passenger, it looks like. This lifts up. And right in here we have a little tray, felt lined. And the tray is removable, so you can dump it and clean it or whatever. Then you have this big storage bin in here, so you can put all kinds of stuff in there. The rearview mirror is manual adjustments for the day and night mode. Place to put your sunglasses, and looks like a pretty big place, so you can put your Hollywood sunglasses or whatever in there. You have some tap lights up here. You can turn all your interior lights on by pushing that button, and you can make it to where they'll turn on and off with the door. The visors have mirrors and lights in them, like so. The visors will also slide out, so we can slide those out and kind of get the right position to kind of stop the sun from trying to blind you while you're driving. So that seems to be an issue sometimes. And check it out, it has this little place here to stop the sun from around the visor, which that's a place where the sun likes to squeeze through all the time. So we got the same thing on that side. Let's take a look at the visibility in the back. All right. Okay, so we've got headrests that are kind of out of the way, but they're still significant and help with the safety. You have little windows back there on the sides, which helps out with your blind spots. See pretty good. Nice big glass. None of the windows are really obstructed too much. All right, there you have it. Let me know what you think in the comment section. This is a really comfortable and awesome vehicle. It's just really easy to drive. It has electric power steering. Just a really, really comfortable vehicle. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions or comments, leave it in the comment section. And thank you for watching. Thank you to Sparks Toyota here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, for allowing me to show off an awesome vehicle. And I'll see you guys next time.